All right, everybody, welcome to what we're calling the Emerald Rockstar Promotion Strategy Brainstorm Session. This was just sort of a brainstorm impromptu thing that happened a couple of days ago. So there was some discussion on our Emerald Rockstars page about people promoting and ideas, and I know like Rachel posted something and Erge posted something. So I started seeing some really great stuff that people were, you know, talking about ideas of what was going on and how to sort of get yourself to that spot of Emerald and how to incentivize and contest and stuff. And I know we started doing the Senior Ruby kind of Friday brainstorms back in September. And so I, as a Senior Ruby then, became what I feel like such great friends with so many of you guys and of the people on the Emerald Rockstars page. And we've been sort of walking and locking arm in arm every week and talking about ideas, and so much of my personal, what I feel like business growth and success, and so many of my ideas came from this exact format of us doing that on Friday mornings. And so when I started seeing that discussion, I thought, wow, we should just kind of hop on. We're mid-month in April. There's so many of what I feel like are some of my best friends, Senior Rubies, that are this close to going Emerald, whether it be this month or next month or the month after. And the coolest part is we're all going to be in Hawaii together, right? I mean, that's going to happen. And so we are going into Hawaii. We are leaders in this company, and we're going all the way to Diamond together. And so being able to do it in this format, I just think it's kind of cool that it's just kind of impromptu. So I wanted to tell you guys, I started like kind of threw it out there like, hey, let's jump on. And I thought it would just be like a Friday morning brainstorm. And it will be, and everybody's just kind of going to roll with it. But you know what? I was just kind of, God really laid something on my heart today. I don't know, like all day I've been thinking about how anticipating and excited about getting with you guys and doing this. And I just kept hearing over and over from him was really to touch on success. Because I know that, and I'm sure I speak for many of you guys, that definition of success for most of us is so much bigger than ourselves. It is so much more than getting 1,500 points. It is so much more than that trip to Hawaii. It is so much more than getting the Lexus and the kudos and the title and all of the really wonderful kind of benefits that come from that Emerald status. But I know that I probably speak for many of you guys. It is so much bigger than ourselves. And God is so, I know for me, has been so in this from the beginning. And it's been about really praying, God, this has got to be your thing, because this is bigger than me and the momentum and all of it. And it's something that I personally couldn't really handle from the time I started as a homeschooling mom of five to the time I got to Emerald to right now. You guys, I went Emerald, you know, back in December and throughout my whole cancer journey and all of it. And so really praying and giving this business to him and praying like everything depends on him and then working like everything depends on us, I think is so, I just wanted to kind of throw that out there as we kind of start this discussion, really reminding ourselves that it is, you know, at the end of the day, it is going to be it's so awesome to finally get to that point, because I know everybody on this call, whether you're a Senior Ruby and you're this close to Emerald, or maybe you're an Emerald and you're working on, I don't know, there's probably lots of different places, but for whatever the reason, everybody on this call is already a proven leader. I mean, everybody here has started from nothing and is built to something and has worked hard. And I know all of our journeys are so different. They've all looked very, very different, but I can pretty much guarantee that we all have a few things in common. We've had really, really great days, and we've had really, really hard days. We probably shed some tears over this business. We've had to sacrifice a lot of things in order to get to this place, but we've loved every single minute of it. And we have people that on our team and maybe in our lives through this Plexus business that we would say, if I just did it for that one person to change that one person's life, to make a difference in that person's life, I would do the same exact thing. And so I know that the culture of this company is, it's so much more about outwardly looking to the people and the things, the way that we're going to, that we've changed lives and the future lives that we're going to change so much more than ourselves. And like I said, getting all the stuff that comes with it. So anyway, I just wanted to kind of start with that because that was just really laid on my heart today. And so I think that, you know, really success is going to be when, and many of you I know are right on the edge, when you get to that emerald level, something does happen. I mean, there's no question that happened for me in December. You kind of jump into this place of, you've met that goal, that probably that dream that you had when you first started, where you got to that level of saying, oh my gosh, I finally sort of arrived. I finally gotten there. But one thing that I've realized more than anything is more than it for ourselves, what it represents to the people on our team is you become the model of hope. And you become the model of the dream being fulfilled. And so that is such an important leadership role. Because we represent, when we get to this place of emerald, sapphire, and diamond, we represent something to our team members, whether they just started yesterday or they're a silver struggling for gold or wherever they are, to say, oh my gosh, you know, Barry did it. Oh my gosh, Brandy did it. Julie did it. If she can do it, I can do it. And so that's a great responsibility as a leader. And with that, it's a wonderful responsibility, but it's a very important responsibility. So I want to, before I kind of open it up and say, let's talk about kind of where we are and, you know, what we're doing and strategizing and all the fun that we're going to have on this conversation. I really just want to start out with prayer because I really want this to be something that that God is in with us, because this is much bigger than us. So I'm just going to do that. So Lord, just thank you for this time. Thank you for the 37 people that have come on the call tonight that are just so passionate about sharing Plexus, for all of the wonderful benefits, Lord, the health, the spiritual, the mental, all of it, that have come together, this community of women that are strong and fierce and bold and just doing amazing things and breaking ceilings and breaking molds and doing just incredible things, God. And we just thank you for this opportunity to be doing this, to be in this position right now on the verge of something so grand, the verge of emerald, the verge of sapphire, and then eventually diamond, guys. We just thank you for that. We pray that you would be in this conversation, that you would fill each of us with your spirit. And so as we're sharing, that they are really your words, and that we would be speaking to each other and inspiring one another, and to be doing something that is so God-honoring, that glorifies you in every single way. So we thank you for this time together. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, that was my speech, y'all. But it was on my heart today, and I'm not even sure all the things were in my head and on my heart actually said, so I don't even know how that all came out. But what I do want to do is just kind of fly with this thing, because this is exciting. If you're on this call, maybe you are really close to Emerald. Maybe it's a couple months away, but we want to support each other in kind of, you know, what you're doing right now to kind of push it forward and to get to that spot. And so does anybody want to talk now and kind of open it up? I'm going to call on somebody if somebody doesn't speak up. Jill, I'm going to call on Jill because I see her right there. I got you. Jill, what's going on? Oh, she's muted. You're muted, Jill.
Okay. Hey, how are you?
Hey.
Nothing like some pressure.
I know, right?
All right. So, you know, it's so interesting the way that you started it out, because up until my senior Ruby point, it was all about push, 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 and point stalking and getting there. And I don't know, ever since then, I've just kind of been like, okay, enough about me. And now it's about focus on the team. And so, I mean, I kind of know what my points are at. I don't know how I'm going to end the month. It could happen this month. I'm thinking, though, it's going to happen in May. And I'm like, you know what, God? For the first month in a long time, I'm just not going to freak out about this. And I'm just taking my hands off the wheel and I'm letting you drive this machine. I'm doing the best that I can do, and just really helping others to promote. And I know this sounds like really cliche-ish, because up until a couple months ago, it was just about, you know, like kind of make it happen. So I'm really not doing a lot. I'm not going to help a lot on this call. I'm sorry.
That's okay. That's cool. No, that's really good. That's awesome. That's good. I know I called on you, Jill, because I just saw your beautiful face and your pink shirt. You look so pretty.
I'm doing a pot of gold for the last 10 months, for the last 10 days of the month. And that's going to be about, you know, for every ambassador, $10 goes in and my leaders are going to share that with me. And so that is really, you know, stacking people. Mm-hmm. And then I am going to run if we become an Emerald team this month, I'm going to split a bonus that I'm receiving from my upline with them.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to do that incentive and then we'll just kind of see. Yeah.
Yeah. Awesome.
Okay.
Anybody else want to throw something out there, something that they're doing right now that seems to be working really well? They want to share with everybody?
Dawn, I'll go ahead and share.
Thanks, Randy.
I did, in the very beginning, I did an incentive for everyone to get their backup orders set by April 15th. And we've had a good turnout for that, so I don't have to stop points toward the end. So that was exciting because we ended up hitting our goal, and a lot of our team members are really excited about that. So we still have a lot that haven't done it, but now we know, you know, a lot of those points are going to be, you know, they're set, we're there. So it's exciting.
Is this your month, Brandy?
Oh, I don't know. I hope so. I'm at 767. So I'm 200 points higher than I was last month. So we had a pretty good growth in February and in March. So hoping that it is, but if not this month, then maybe next month.
Everybody going to convention, Emerald. That's cool.
Yes.
Exciting.
Yeah,
and I'm sure everybody, the 15%, I'm sure it helps everybody. That's been huge.
Yes.
Okay, I know something. I'll share something I did because I'm actually pushing for Sapphire this month. Oh my goodness. So I wanted to do the same thing because me personally in December, it was like right around Christmas and I had no idea that I was even close to Emerald. And so I ended up having to be very stressed out the last like 3 days of the month, freaking out like down to the 31st, you know, almost. I thought I was going to have to go all the way to midnight. So I didn't want to do that again. And so I thought I'd be a little more proactive this time. And so did much the same thing. So set a contest from the 1st to the 15th of the month. Of course, now we're past that, but you could do something, you know, like it, where anybody, so really focus on the new people that were joining. So anybody that was new that joined, then they did $100 over their PV. I actually did a free product, which turned out to be fine because of the 15% discount. So that was really, you know, it turned out to be fine, but that was really good. Like that helped out a lot. So doing really focusing, I think, on the newbies, which I know is, you know, everybody knows to do that, but really focusing on them to try to get them to their $100 PV. Some other things that we've done is tried to get them to buy, like offering them samples. So if they get to their $100 PV, you know, we'll give you 2 7-day samples or 1 7-day sample that you can give out to people or something. So that's been good. So it's Yvonne. Yvonne raised her hand. Where are you at, Yvonne? Did you mean to raise your hand, Yvonne? I didn't even know you could do that. I don't know. I guess not. I guess she didn't mean to.
Dawn, can I ask you a quick question before
she... Oh, can it?
Oh, I'm sorry.
There she is. Hey, Yvonne.
I'm sorry, you can go and I can go after you.
No, I was just going to ask about your new people that join. If you're offering that incentive, it's going to be over their welcome pack as well then. So $100 over their welcome pack.
Right.
Is that right? Okay.
Yeah, right. They'd have to do $100. Once they do $100, obviously once the points are registered, they get a free product or free samples or something like that to encourage them to get going. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Yvonne?
Yeah. So I'll just share some contests. I'm pushing for Sapphire this month. I thought it was going to be next month, but my husband woke up the other day and he decided that this was going to be the month that I'm going to go Sapphire. And he posted on my team page that we're pushing for Sapphire. And I'm like, I wish you would have told me because I would have told you like the points, like how those, you don't know that part. But... because I said I felt more comfortable going for it for next month. But you know what? I'm kind of glad he did it. I was kind of like, I hate your guts right now. I can't believe you did this. Like, the pressure is on. I never want to announce to my team that I'm close. Well, everyone, like, obviously was rallying up behind me. But this, there are some contests that I did, kind of what I did for Emerald, and something that I've always done is I encourage all of my ambassadors to get commission qualified in the first week of the month. This is something that I'm huge on. I'll do that's my flash contest. I'll give away like a Plexus swag bottle or whatever. Just because, as you guys know, how our points are. And I talk to my team, and I set the expectation with my leaders that are my level ones. I was like, if you have more than 10 people on your team, I expect for you to be commission qualified and set the example to be commission qualified for the first week of the month. And I explained to them on the importance, and some of them obviously don't get it at the beginning, but when they start trying to like rank up to gold and stuff, they get it. So I love how they have encouraged my team. Some contests that I was doing to add Sapphire was like a pot of gold contest. For every new ambassador that we add, levels 1 through 4, I'll add $10 to a pot at the end of the month. We'll divide up the pot 3 ways. The person that recruited the most gets half the pot, and then other 2 people will draw your names. And the contest, or what I did for Sapphire, what I did at the beginning of the month, is I actually had already had messaged all of my inactives that I've had. And I had already, like, sent them a message asking them, what's going on? Like, why did having you order? Why did you order last month? What can I do to help you with the product? Just to let you know, you have 15% off. And if you decide to order, these are the people, because I had already messaged one group of inactives on January 1st. And they kind of already told me who was in and who was out. So these were the people that might have joined in February, might have joined in March, or, like, in January, and they just decided not to order last month. So I sent all those, like, that email, just asking what's going on, if they needed help troubleshooting. I introduced them like I am their jewel upline, and also tell them, you know what, why don't you go ahead and order? You'll save 15% off if you order by April 15th, and then I'll offer you, like, a $5 reimbursement. I actually had a huge success with that. And I also do a separate contest. I kind of do a lot when I push for a promotion. My separate contest I have right now is just for newbies. It is kind of hard. Like, I hate pushing new ambassadors to get commission qualified. There's been, you know how, because they're not going to get anything. They're not going to get anything for selling a triplex combo, because Plexus keeps the first $100, you know. So I do a contest where it's a guarantee win for them. So I pretty much tell my newbies, if you get $100 over your welcome pack, I'll give you a $10 reimbursement, or sometimes even a little bit more, depending on what I'm needing at when it comes to points towards that, you know, that time frame. I feel like if they have a guaranteed contest that they're going to win, they will help you order to, like, you know, help promote you. And I work with my team that's about to promote. So if I have someone that's about to go gold or senior gold, I ask them, well, how many people do you need to, like, place orders? We'll talk to points. And I make sure if I'm going to do a contest, I do it with their team, because if I get them promoted, obviously it helps you. So I pick my people that are going to get promoted to silver, whatever's going to help them to get promoted. I'll also focus a lot of my contests around their teams.
Very good. Yeah. Actually, you reminded me of something. I did this month. I think this is kind of fun with a team contest. I looked at my senior gold teams and my really strong gold teams, and I gave them an incentive. And I said, the team that adds the most new people, levels 1 through, most of them are like levels 1 through 5. I was actually going to give them $350 towards doing a team event. So it had to be like a community building event. So they could use it for like a retreat, they could use it for a dinner, they could use it for a photo shoot, something. So my thinking was, if I got my team leaders really excited at the beginning of the month and really rallied to kind of push their teams, that would ultimately, of course, you know, help me as well. And that's been pretty cool. I mean, they've been excited about that, and they've all planned, like, one of them's going to have a cookout, and she's like, you know, talking about her cookout on her team page, and one of them wanted to do a photo shoot. So anyway, that was a fun idea, but that's gone pretty good.
I totally agree with Yvonne. I just recently started doing like contests for early commission qualifiers, and I'm surprised how responsive they were with just a little bit of Plexus swag. I mean, we were able to get like 45 commission qualified by the 15th of the month.
Get your arm up.
So I definitely like what Yvonne brings me a little bit of comfort that I'm a little bit on this on the right path.
Yeah, I had never done that. That's a good idea. I never really thought about like worried about the beginning of the month, so that's good. Okay. Anybody else got anything that they've got going on right now they want to share?
I'll talk for a second. Yeah. So I've been doing a contest this month. I don't know if everyone knows, but my story was I was very far in November and just kind of dropped back. I had parts of my team kind of fall apart during the back office, didn't know what was happening until after it was like kind of exploding backwards. So I'm back up, back in the race, which I'm excited about. So this month, what I've done for my team is I have a big drawing that kind of opens up as soon as we get like 40 entries or 40 people. But each time we get 10 new ambassadors, I do a drawing. So that's been exciting, and then I kind of do a countdown as I go. So every time we get a new ambassador on this thread, I'd be sure and like congratulate them for getting their new ambassador. Tell them we're like, now we're 9 points away. Now, you know, Lana just added someone. Now we're 8 points or eight drawings away or eight entries away. And so I do a countdown each time, and it's gotten a lot of momentum. We've added 43 people so far, which for my team is pretty good. So I think that that's been good, and then people are excited, and everyone, you know, goes crazy for those Swell water bottles. So that's what they've been choosing, even though we have some different options of things that they can choose when they win the drawing. So that's been really great. And then obviously once we hit, we hit the 40, but I think someone was for me, and I'm pulling myself out of the drawing. But once we hit the 40, then we're opening it up for the big contest. So that's
so explain it. So you every time you get 10 ambassadors, you do a drawing. So anybody that added, that contributed to the 10 is in the drawing.
Correct. So what I did I have a big drawing for like a mini iPad. And that is, and so in order to open up that drawing, we have to have so many people that have been added. So 40 some ambassadors have to be added, like the ones I personally add, because I'm not going to include myself in the drawings. So that means mine are just kind of bonus on the cake. But every time 10 people are added, then I do, like I start doing a countdown. I'm like, okay, now we're on number two, we're on drawing number three. But it's been really great because people are really excited, and we have been adding people just right and left. And even people who hadn't added a bunch of people are excited about this. So, and then I'm encouraging my other leaders to do little mini contests that they can do so that their teams can, potentially win a couple different things. And I'm sure I'm going to do some kind of flash things coming up, but I just haven't figured out exactly what those are going to be.
Mm-hmm. That's good. I like that.
Yeah, and then we're starting another 7 days of silver and 7 days group for all of our newbies as well. So that starts tomorrow. So hopefully we'll have some more people promoting the silver this month and just kind of getting that momentum right off the bat, especially some of these new ones since we had added so many. So my goal is that at least 10 of the 40 go silver the next week as well, so that their momentum continues to grow.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I've seen a lot of really good success with the silver and seven stuff.
Yeah.
You guys, if you haven't seen that, guys, it's really a good, it's all templated, so it's easy to do, but it's pretty good.
Yeah, I think we're going to do some tomorrow Holloway's videos on ours, so it'll mm-hmm. be good.
Mm-hmm. Okay, cool. Thank you for sharing.
You're welcome.
Someone talk about the silver. I haven't actually done the silver and seven. I've just seen it, and some of my team leaders have done it. Has anybody done the silver and seven that wants to talk about it?
I'll say something about it. Mm-hmm. So we actually started the silver and 7 days in February, and what I actually did is the first 7 days of every month, we just had seven challenges for the first 7 days. So we restarted every single month on the first 7 days, and that actually has actually really worked out well for us.
Oh, I like that.
So we use Tamara Holloway's videos too. She has the 1 through 7s, but we also created our own videos with our own team members with tips and also with challenges for each day. So they have to comment in the threads every time they complete a challenge for the day. Mm-hmm. And we did giveaways for people that, were in all the challenges. We put all their names in a drawing and did like giveaways for like swag and things like that. But we've had really good success with the silver in 7 days, and it's not something hard to do. I just did a scheduled Hootsuite every time I did it, so that I at least posted the challenges for those first 7 days, so that obviously those were already posted, and then anything I posted extra was just icing on the cake. So that really worked well for us.
Do you do it on your team page, or do you have a separate page for it?
No, we have a separate page. We created a page that's just for the Silver in 7 days. And then whenever we do our new ambassador calls, we make sure that everybody's on those Silver in 7 days groups. And if we're not in the challenge at the time, that they go back to those 1 through 7 challenges and then reach out to their sponsor and tell them that they've completed the challenges and how that's going for them too.
Okay. But you launch it at the first of the month officially.
Yes, we do it every month, the first through the seventh, every single month.
Mm, that's pretty cool.
I like that.
I do too. Okay. We got a bunch of chats here. Hang on. Sarah Taylor has videos too. Let's see. That's what Yvonne says. You guys see the chat right there? Okay. I'm writing.
I believe Melissa Eichenhorst also has a Silver in 7, and all her challenges are video-based as well.
She does.
So lots of options.
There are. Yes. There's a ton on there. But I have to say that Rachel pushed me out of my comfort zone on the last Friday call, and she said, Amy, you don't do your own videos? And I said, no, I don't like to talk on video. You know, like I don't like to do them. But I did them, all 7 of them, my own, and my team was so excited, and it was neat to see how they were excited for me and, like, felt like every day they're like, oh, my gosh, you got better today. You did such a great job. But I think having them watch me do it myself versus Tamara, or, you know, like, I just copied them. I mean, I did the same thing, but I did it myself, like, really pushes them out of their comfort zone, too. You know, and got really excited about it. So I don't know. That's a tip for me. That really, it brought us all together, because now they're so much more excited for me being the leader than they were before I started it, if that makes sense.
Yeah, you're making
that.
It very
good job. Personal. That's great.
So. Making it very personable.
Right.
I love that. That's good. Okay.
I also sent an email out today to all 40 people that have been added this month, as well as anyone who was added last month and the month before, and just told them, kind of just a short, like, one-liner, introduced myself, and then told them about, like, this Google Drive document that we have, which has just different files in it, and then also told them about the Silver in 7 days. So, you know, I don't know if I'll get a bunch of responses, because you know how people look at emails, but I kind of flashed it out and made it kind of different. So I'm hoping that some of the people that are brand new, that have no idea what we're doing here and talking about, and are just like, wow, I just wanted these products wholesale, might get enthusiastic about doing this event with us. So, I mean, just 7 days with us. So That's my hopes.
Very good.
Barry, do you ever reach out to them on Facebook, or do you just strictly do through the email?
Both, you know, I welcome people and say hello and try to get the people who added them to do some 3 ways. I have a lot of level 2s that I'm very, very close with lately. So I know that just kind of reaching out and trying to make those connections to some of these other people is so important. And I feel like that's what happened with my team when I kind of got lost, is that I didn't realize that there was a really huge lack of connection. And I think that's the biggest thing in this business, is that, you know, they have no idea. People have no idea who we are or what we're doing. And they're brand new, and they're like going, like, we have no idea. And so trying to make a connection and making them feel important outside of just the person who signed them up, I think is huge for me. I know that for myself, I mean, Erin Key is my sponsor and best friend. And so something coming from her is great, but something coming from someone above her kind of felt special. I mean, not to mention that she is special, but I mean, she's my best friend. So, you know, coming from someone else, it really felt good. And even if I didn't know them really well, I might look them up and go, oh, wow, I might want to get to know them. So I think that special touch and reaching out to people, and I mean, it takes a little while. I'm not an Excel person. So Erin literally has to take 2 seconds to download it and do it for me and just send me my people, which I'm grateful for her to do that. But it took her like 2 seconds while we were talking. So I guess I'll be learning that application and trying to figure it out very soon. Mm-hmm. But I, you know, I, again, I don't know how many people are going to respond to that email from some random person. Especially since I got all these emails from Plexus this weekend, you know, as soon as I signed up. But hopefully that, you know, some people will. And I think that those that want it will. I have a whole lot of people are all of a sudden really interested in the business, which is amazing. They want it all. So I feel like it's kind of like the word's really getting out and people are really getting interested in not only our products, but the business. So it's exciting.
Yeah. Well, you know, when you said that reminded me of something that, that I do, Odie, is whenever someone's announced on my team page, I used to always try to friend them immediately, but what I found was many times those people don't really become really active, and then I'm not really sure who they are anymore unless they really show up a lot as being very active. So instead of doing that, I'll actually kind of click their name off of the team page, go to their Facebook profile, not necessarily friend them, but send a messenger. Now, I know that sometimes it can get filtered out, but send a messenger and just use my voice because for time purposes, and just say, hi, this is Dawn Andrews. I just wanted to welcome you to the team. We're so glad to have you. You know, reach out to me anytime. Send me a friend request. So I kind of put it in their ballpark if they wanted to friend request me. I don't know.
That's just
something, because it's easy and quick. I don't know. I just am always so time-pressed to send a lot of emails and look things up in the back office. But I have found that that's been great. And a lot of times people, or another thing I do sometimes is send text, because that's easy on a phone. You know, you can see their number and just send them a quick text. Hey, welcome to the team. You know, and anyway. But I have found that has been good, that it's helped me to connect with some of the people that aren't just my level ones.
Right. Yeah. I mean, I recently just reached out to somebody that, you know, has been maybe in the business year, and I can say that she appreciated just reaching out knowing that I was there. So I definitely totally agree. I feel that a lot of the people do stick around in the business is because of the support and the encouragement we have, even on the challenging days. So, you know, some people that may be struggling, maybe not silver in 2 years, and they just can't find the right group of people, but because of the support and the encouragement, they haven't given up in the business.
Right.
Definitely. And the reason why I like to use Facebook is so I know if they've read the message or not.
Yeah.
You know, that's like my way of saying, I know you saw my message. I know you read it. Please respond.
I just like to keep up with it better when it's on Facebook. Personally.
That's why I was curious of Barry, like if she uses both, or, you know, what is the response rate when she just sends out an email?
Yeah.
Not as good as when I message them. I mean,
right? Yeah.
I've had like 20 respond today out of, I don't know, you know, 70 or 80 or 100 on that, something like that.
Yeah, that's pretty good though. That's a good rate.
Yeah.
Good rate of return. All right. Anybody have any questions? I mean, I know, you know, I remember, and I just remember what it was like getting ready to go Emeralds, and you kind of, I swear, I think it feels like the first time you give birth, like to your first baby, it's like your belly's out to here, and you know, like everybody's telling you you're going to have a baby, but you really don't believe it, because you're like, I don't know, it could be a watermelon, not really sure this is really going to happen, like you just really can't wrap your mind around what it's actually going to be like and feel like. I don't know, that's how I went, and so, you know, if as you're kind of in that place right now, or mid-month, and maybe this is your month, and does anybody have any questions?
I do.
What they can, you know, instead of offering something?
I do.
Yay, yes.
Who are you calling on?
I don't know, whoever said me.
I believe that was Jill.
Okay.
All right, so I know there's no stupid questions, but this is a really stupid question, because I know what commission qualified means, but you guys are talking about like getting your people commission qualified in the first 15 days. So I don't know what you mean, because if they have their backup order turned on, but it's not going to ship out till the 26th of the month, I'm a little confused about that.
Like why it matters?
Well, so for me personally, those people that do rely on maybe their backup order, we were holding contests, so we try to get them involved. So rather than them relying on their backup order, the only way that they would be able to qualify and be involved in the contest is if they went in and manually placed an order. So, you know, maybe they would be up for a $100 cash prize if they went in and manually placed an order, rather than relying on their backup order. We were trying to get more involvement from those that maybe were wholesalers or that rely on their backup order. So personally, it was just either an order was placed before maybe the 10th or the 15th of the month, or they found a customer by that time before they having to, rather than relying on their backup order.
So you're basically front loading your points, right?
Right. Yes.
Okay.
And another reason, if you don't mind, I do it too. And like I said, I set the expectations for my leaders. I have more than 10 people on their team, just because now with the back, how the way the back office is, how our points fluctuate, it just, it makes it so hard for you to point stock when you have a senior Ruby or someone like that waiting to the last minute to qualify, thinking that you have those points to go. And the minute that she qualifies, because what happens when, like, when your strong leader is in commission qualified to the end of the month, her levels bump up all the way up. So it compresses up to you. And whenever she decides to come commission qualified at the last minute, all those points go down because she's become commission qualified. So that's another reason why I do it. And it builds excitement for everyone to get commission qualified at the beginning of the month.
Yeah. And you really don't, I'm like me personally, you really don't realize or understand compression until your team starts to get so large, because as you're building your team, you really don't recognize your points dropping until your team starts to grow. Mm-hmm. Like the larger your team gets, you'll start to see the compression if you don't have the leaders commission qualified early on. I mean, some leaders I know personally have dropped like 200 to 300 points at the end of the month because their leaders don't get commission qualified till the end.
Well, and I understand people in the beginning that are just starting, they might think they can't afford to get the products for themselves until the very end of the month, or maybe on the certain, you know, certain date of the month. But when we're paid on the 15th every single month, even sometimes earlier when we, you know, last several months, it's been early.
Right.
I mean, there's really no excuse for them not to go ahead and get commission qualified before the 15th. So that's right. Kind of the way we presented it to our team this year, this month. And it
went really well. We've got the point expert on the Galat call. So I need right now to give, all right, Erge, where are you?
I'm here.
This I'm not sure I'm ready for it at 10 o'clock at night where I can wrap my head around what you're getting ready to tell us. But I have a pen and paper this time, so I'm ready.
Okay, you can hear me, right?
Yes.
All right, I'm just going to get right to it.
Yes.
Hang on, let me see if I can get another window open. I'm going to go ahead and share my screen with you guys and show you how to do it. All right, so the point is, of course, for one, I jumped in the call late, so I apologize for that. But the conversation about front loading your month and making sure leaders are qualified, or trying to make sure everybody gets qualified before the 15th, I completely agree with all of that. However, you shouldn't be dumbfounded when your points go down when that happens. You should know that's exactly what's happening. When you look at your points, you should be able to tell whether those are real points or not. Does that make sense? All right. I'm going to go ahead and share my screen. The first thing, let me just ask, does everybody know how to download their genealogy report? Like download it. Do you know how to download it? If you don't, if everybody knows it, I'll just skip that part. But essentially on your genealogy report, there's a little, oh, okay. All right. Let me go ahead and just show it real quick. Easy peasy. Okay. Here we go. You can see my screen, I hope.
Uh-huh.
I'm just going to go ahead and log in to my account. And I'm going to go to my detailed genealogy. And I usually just do 7 levels, even though through compression, because there are people that turn off or whatever completely, I might get points from my lower levels, but I always project as low as possible. So I just do 0 to 7 and then click on this little folder thing. And that downloads a CSV file, a CSV file. You see a bunch of them downloaded because I actually project points for my team all the time. So now I downloaded the CSV file. What I'm going to do next is I'm going to share my screen with you again. And I'm going to open that, actually import that file into Excel. Disclaimer, I'm working on a Mac. This is a little different on a Windows machine, but you'll get the gist of it. So I'm going to show you how I do it on a Mac. So I'm going to my Excel, and on a Mac, there is the import option, and I'm going to import a CSV file. Import, and it's on my desktop, the thingamajig I just downloaded. My desktop is a mess, as you can see. So I click next. Now here, things look kind of funky, right? It's okay. I click next. They're starting to get organized. On the other field, I put the little line, which is right above the enter button on my keyboard. And then I go next. And then I go down here, and the date ones, enrollment date, renewal date, upgrade date. I select those, and I identify them as date, year, month, day. And then I click finish. I just click, yeah, okay, import them here. Now look how pretty that looks. Everything is in here. And then I go, now, are you following me so far? I'm going to stop for a second. Are you following me so far, or are you like completely lost?
Let me see. I'm kind of like starting kind of with you.
You're not following me. Okay.
Well, I think,
now,
most people.
Where are you missing me? On the download? Okay.
Just when you started clicking in those little boxes.
Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Just keep on clicking next. That will even work.
Okay.
And what you're trying to do is essentially your detailed genealogy, you're trying to get it into Excel in a readable format.
Mm-hmm. And,
all this thing that I'm showing, I have a YouTube video on it. I'll find it and send it to you, Dawn, or we can put it on the page.
Mm-hmm.
But in a nutshell, I just kind of am downloading the, I am downloading the CSV file, and I'm importing that into Excel. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Now, once I have it in Excel is when the magic is going to start happening. I'm going to really start messing around with it. So speak up and stop me, because I tend to go, you know. So, all right. So now, this is what I had important. So I'm going to go to Welcome PV column, and I'm going to go to Data and sort it. I'm going to sort it one more time because I want the Welcome PVs there. All these ones that have a Welcome PV, I'm going to select them, cut them out of here because I don't want to see them when I'm projecting points. I will come back to them, but I just move them to a different sheet and I name that sheet Newbies. And delete the empty cells. I actually even copied this identifier and paste that. When I pasted it here, I started with the second row. So now I have everyone before March, essentially, watching. In here.
What are they doing?
So what I'm going to do is go to backup autoship volume and sort that also. All these zeros are backup order off. Attrition. Ooh. Actually, some people have, you know, 90s and 95s. I treat them as backup order off too. I'm going to cut those, add the new sheet, and go to the second line, paste them there, name that sheet AQ off. Delete the empty cells, copy that, put it in here. Okay. Now on this very first sheet, I have everyone on here, essentially on that first screen, that used the first sheet on the Excel sheet, is everyone that you will think of as blue lines. Okay. The next thing I do is I sort it by level. I insert a new column next to the level column.
I go in manually, put in points that I expect from those people. Once that's all done, I add up that column. That's the points I expect from my blue line. If you're like me or like anybody else, you will get points from AQOps or newbies too. Then I go to those two other sheets. Then I go to those and sort them by the PV they have. And then I add the points I get from some of those that are already over 100 PV. And then add everything up. At the end, the points I see is the total points, the minimum total points I should get, not including compression at all. Like, you know, treating it like everybody just went through today. The only assumption here is, of course, that I'm not going to have any entered statuses. So any given month, I will lose about 100 to 200 points on backup orders that don't go through. So the projection I look at, I usually think about it as, it's going to be 100 points less than that.
Mm.
So that's how I do it.
That
I mean, I can go forward and show you the rest of it, but this is important.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what I really recommend doing is identify those people that are close to ranking up.
Mm-hmm.
And last month, I had, in my team, there were 22 promotions. I'm not even lying, I didn't push for Sapphire. I didn't. I pushed for one of them to go Ruby, another one to go Ruby, another one to go Senior Ruby, someone to go Senior Gold. That's what I pushed for. And I, for my, one of my level ones that made Ruby, another one that made Senior Ruby, we're not even thinking about it, about promoting. The Ruby, I was projecting her to be at 400 points, finishing, like when I did all of this, I said she's gonna finish at 400 points. Oh, Ruby is only 100 points away. That's doable. So I went to her team page, I talked to her, and I said, I'm gonna do a contest on your team page, just for your team. Not before the 27th, 28th.
Mm-hmm.
I wait for all the AQs to go, and I want to see the final number, and then do a flash contest only for those that are under 100 PV. And it is usually, you know, if you go over 100 PV, you'll get 20 from me, the first 10 people. There's a question.
Claire, you have a question? Where are you, girl? You have to unmute yourself. I muted you.
All right. I think I'm unmuted now. Thank you.
You are.
So this just is not directly what Ergie was talking about, but thank you so much. But it brought up another point about those that are entered and it never processes. What do you guys do about that? It's making me insane.
I do something about it. You want me to tell you?
Yeah. Tell me what you do.
I call customer service and have their backup orders turned off. If 2 months in a row they're in entered status, I call and say turn it off, and they turn it off.
Right. So you don't. Yeah. So that's a good idea.
So I mean, I'm not getting any points from doing that, but at least I just go like, go away.
Yeah.
Backup order off.
Yeah. I mean, I know I've reached out. I mean, trying to get with the. You guys have probably done it too, of course. Reach out to whoever the sponsor is. Hey, so-and-so, can you get in touch with this person, find out what's going on, let's send them a message. Hey, did you know that your card's not going through or whatever, there's a problem. I mean, that's worked some, but usually what? Somebody overmaxed that other card or something that's not going to fix itself. Right?
I also don't depend on people contacting people. I'm just going to say it. It doesn't always happen. I do every couple of months. Not every month necessarily, but probably every couple of months.
Yeah.
I send out an email to all my inactive level 1 through 7.
Mm-hmm.
And in that email, I tell them,
mm-hmm.
if you do not want products, please go turn your backup order off. And then I say, if you would like to cancel your membership, keep in mind, having your backup order off doesn't mean your ambassadorship is canceled. you need to cancel it. Here's the cancellation form, and I send the cancellation form link.
Yeah, I don't know where that crackle is coming from. Someone just asked about it. It's happening to me too. I tried to go through a mute, but I'm not sure where that's coming from. I don't know what the problem is. It looks like everybody's muted, so I don't know why we're having a crackle. Maybe if someone's on the phone, maybe that's what it is, a phone person. Yep, that seems better. That seems better. I will say, I've had this happen to me before. I think it was a phone person, where I've gone to... I've gone around a level one or a level two or whatever to reach out in that manner. And it's come back, that leader has come back to me and said, hey, I was already working with that person. I've got a good relationship with that person. Please don't go around me. I don't know if you guys have ever had that happen before, but I have. And, you know, so I think you, I've learned the people that I can't go around and the people that I can. Anyway. But I won't do, I don't necessarily do it always across the board that way because of that reason, trying to be respectful of my leaders who would rather do it themselves.
I have a leaders page, mm-hmm. and I let my leaders know ahead of time that this is what I'm going to do.
Speak up
and tell me you don't want me to contact them. Tell me what you are doing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That crackle came back, y'all.
Is it me?
No, I don't think so. I mean, I don't. It's weird.
Let me mute and see if it goes away.
Yeah, it went away. But I don't want you to mute. I want to hear from you. That doesn't work. We'll just have to deal with the crackle to hear Erge. But I have to say that was very, she's explained that to me before and I need to hear it like probably 10 times to get it. So we're going to have another, maybe we'll have I'll watch your video and then I can replay it to figure that out. But really great. I love that because I talked to my team about this a lot too. I was like, we're business owners. When you get to this level, you know, you're a jewel now. You own your business. And part of being a good, savvy business owner is understanding how to run your business, right? And being able to understand how to run your points and how, so all of these things, even though I know for me, that's a huge comfort zone thing, not getting Excel, not understanding how to do that. But like everything else in this business, when you reach that point of like not getting it, you got to push yourself to figure it out. So I really appreciate that. And I know that's going to be on the top of my to-do list to figure it out because we do need to be savvy about how we run it, how we run our business. Okay. I would love to hear from anybody else that has, like we were kind of saying, questions. If you've got like a question, we've got Erge here, who's a sapphire pushing for diamond. We've got other jewels probably on the call that can give really good advice because we've all been there. Like everybody's started with nothing and has had to go through the ranks, right? So we all kind of know what it's like to get to each of those levels. So if anybody else has anything they want to add, questions, ideas, shoot. Okay. Amy, you want to talk about Zooms? The Zoom queen.
Oh my goodness, it's been working really, really well. Can you guys hear me? Should I plug in?
You're good. You look pretty.
Oh, thank you. we did 22 Zoom calls this past week, and I'm telling you, I had 20 or 25 people join just on Friday, and most of them, not all, but many of them came from those. Well, many of them came from the discount being the last day, I'm sure, but many of them really were the Zoom people. So it's going really, really well. And I'm getting my leaders to do it as well. So anyway, I'm making it the standard that you've got to be silver the first 7 days you join. And if you just tell people that, they're doing it. So it's going really, really good. I highly recommend doing that. Is Amy Paul on here? She is seriously like that. She came to our area. I guess last Friday, and it was just exactly what I needed to hear. It's nothing I came up with. I just followed her advice and really have been working it. And I've got, I don't know how many already scheduled for this coming week. I think I have 10 so far.
Awesome. Amy, we're doing some tomorrow night. So I'm,
yay. Hey, it's Agate. I have a question for you because I know it's going to be asked. When you are doing Zoom calls with prospects, mm-hmm. I'm understanding that, right? I mean, you're doing them with...
Yep, there's prospects on them.
how the heck do you get a prospect to go create a Zoom account? That's step one, right?
Right.
I mean, I do three-way calls all the time with prospects, but doing a Zoom is something, I mean, you would have to get that person to agree to create a Zoom account, and then you're going to send them a link, and then they're going to join. You see what
they're
I'm saying?
It. Yeah, but they're doing it. Like, we've had so many on. Like, I've had a Zoom with one person on my call. I just started last Sunday, honestly. It was, like, the first time I did this, but we did 22, and I think I only had two that had nobody. So what I did, for me, it was a little bit easier because right now we have a six-week challenge group going. And so I have all those people in that group who are really wanting to do the business. And then that six-week challenge group, this is the third time I've done that group. It's the same one that Sarah Marble, I think, was the first one who did it. And then Alicia McKee is my upline, and she did it first. So I didn't make up anything. But this is my third round doing it. So this time I have six other, two of them are doing it together. So I really have seven other of my leaders hosting the exact same group that I am. So what I did is in my group, and I told my leaders to do the same thing, and they did, most of them anyway. In that group, I said, okay, if you're not silver yet, who's ready to be silver? And I said, this is what we're going to be doing and whatever. And so I said, if you're ready to be silver or you're ready for your next promotion, I want you to send me your phone number and your sponsor's name and your partner's name, because everybody in the group has partners. And so all of them who were ready, and there was, I think, I have 40 people in the group, so there's 20 groups of partners, and I did 18 calls from that group last week. So anyway, because I basically made it a requirement, and they want, it's a tough love challenge group, so if they don't do it, they're kicked out, and I'm pretty much, they can walk over, you know, like, I'm not usually like a stickler to rules, but if you tell them this is what you've got to do, they did it. So anyway, they gave me their phone number, and I literally just called, and I said, okay, and if you are passionate, and Amy Paul says, be a little bossy, but if you're like, okay, this is what you have to do, and they hear that passion in your voice, I picked up the phone, just like we tell them to do, and I said, okay, I need you to get me 3 to 5 people on a call with me, and for the first phone call, I said, oh, can we do it tomorrow at 3? And she was like, okay. And so the thing is, my question to Amy Pullen, and my question is, how are we going to get these potentials on the call? But the funny thing is, if we're the ones who make that a big deal, you know, like, the only people who, like, were questioning that were not my new people. It was people who've been with me a while. And so anyway, but if they did ask me, like, when I just told them, get me 3 to 5 people, a lot of them just did. But if they're curious of, like, how do I get people on a call, I just told them, pick up the phone, call your mom, your sister, your cousin, your uncle, whoever, and just say, can you please jump on this call with me? You know, I just want you to hear my friend's story 5 to 10. I just need your support. And the first girl I was talking to, she really wants to be a stay-at-home mom. She has a newborn. She's got 2 more weeks left of maternity leave, and she does not want to go back. She's got 2 other little girls. It's just, she does not want to go back. So I said, call your family, whoever, and just tell them, listen, and tell them why. Like, if you don't have a story, it's okay. Tell them why you want this. I want to be home with my babies. I'm not asking you to join me. I'm just asking you to get on this call for your support. I would love your opinion. So if you call someone who loves you and they say that to them, they're not going to tell you no. And if you call 20 people, maybe some will tell you no, but, like, at least 3 to 5 will get on, you know, if you really put forth that effort. And it's just gone really well. So that's how I told them to get on the calls. And then what I did, because it was partners, is the day, because there's so many of them, I couldn't like create all of the Zooms like right then and there. So I just did it the day of. So the day of, like, that afternoon, if my call was in the evening, I put them in a little group chat and I said, okay, I'm so excited for our call tonight at 7:00. I need you to make sure your people are prepared. I'll tell you that in a second. I said, I need you to make sure your people are prepared. So they need to download the app. I just told them, like, if they're on a phone, download the app, or make sure they're on a laptop so they could just click the link. Mm-hmm. So I said, you know, make sure you contact them right now. And I told them I only have 30-minute increments, which I don't recommend that, but that's what I did last week. 30-minute increments, because, and I'm going to have to get off. So, anyway, just make sure they're prepared so we get ready on time. So not every single potential showed up, but we had as many as 11 people on one call, and we had as little as one. And so if we did, we just went with it. I don't know. So I just feel like it's your passion and your, like, you must do this kind of attitude. And they did it.
So, and so now, I think the question too is, it wasn't a big deal for guests to click the blue link or download it. Nobody had a problem with it.
I mean, maybe some people did, but I think because I told them to make sure they know, and I kind of made it clear, we only have 30 minutes, so make sure they're prepared. They just did it. I don't know. I mean, maybe not everyone, but we had a lot.
Mm-hmm. Most people, yeah, people are getting more comfortable with technology.
Yeah.
So someone asked what you do. You share your testimony.
Oh, okay. So
question asking.
Oh yeah. I'm sorry. Let's see. Okay. So I saw somebody ask about the partners. That's a totally different thing. I'm doing a 6-week challenge group. It's the same one and I have a previous one you guys can look, has all the challenges in there, except for I'm tweaking it this time to add the Zoom things in there. Like this week I'm requiring them to do one without me. They're doing it for each other, the partners. So in my 6-week challenge group, everybody's assigned a partner. And so last week I did them for each person. So when we did a call, it was me and two ambassadors on the call. So all I did, and believe me, I kept asking all the leaders, like Sarah Taylor and Amy Paul, and I think, I can never say it, Tamara Holloway. I hope I said that right. But I kept saying, okay, what do you do? Like, especially last week, I was panicking. I was like, what do I do on these calls? Like, what do I say? And all of them said, it's hard to even say that because they're all kind of different. And I just didn't get that until I kept doing them. And I realized, okay, they are different. But all I did was, so if it's me and Dawn and Cheryl on the call, we're ambassadors, and I see Vicky and, I don't know, Jill and Christine, I would be like, if Jill's the guest, I'd be like, oh, Jill, hey, welcome. Are you here just to support Dawn, or is there something, what about Plexus really interests you? And she would be like, oh, I'm here to support her, but I'm also curious about health and wellness, you know, mm-hmm. I eat McDonald's every day, you know, whatever she says. So whatever she says, I can gear it because all of our testimonies, we can touch every aspect, you know? So I would just, in my mind, be like, okay, she eats McDonald's. I know I'm just teasing because Jill's like the queen of health. But I would, you know, just deal that way. So I'd be like, okay, awesome. Well, thank you so much for getting on. I really value your time. And you know what? I also used, you guys go to convention last year with the, it was like Tamara's, she has a Facebook group. Do you know what I'm talking about? Like her convention. So in there, she has a script from, was Lori Harrison and another man. You know what I'm talking about? She has some
Brent.
Script. Mm-hmm. Okay, so I actually pull that up and I use that in meetings all the time. It's just all about, I value your time and blah, blah, blah. Like I kind of read that a little bit depending. And I just tell them, well, thank you for being here. And then I'll say, okay, well, I'm just going to give you a couple minutes of my testimony. I share my story. In my story, I touch on gut health, blood sugar, inflammation. I'll say, you know, I had these awful migraines, and the reason why I believe it works is because that Slim really balances out your blood sugar levels. You know, I'll mention the Triflex products, just like a sentence about the Triflex and the X Factor. And then I'll say, so Dawn, how long have you been doing it? You know, she's my ambassador. And she would be like, and I've warned them, like I told them beforehand, try to practice your testimony 2 or 3 minutes. And if you're brand new, tell them why you want to do it. That's all you got to say. Just why you're doing this. And so she shares a little, Cheryl shares a little. And then at the end, I'd be like, so Jill, did you hear anything tonight that maybe you can relate to or that sparked your interest? And I so far have just about everybody say, well, yeah, I didn't know it could do blah, blah, blah. Or yeah, I really do would love to stay home with my, they always touch on the business part because, you know, at our level, we have quite a story. So anyway, that's me. I am not the professional. I didn't mean to take over. I just, it's been working this week for me. I actually had a lady join tonight that I did, wasn't a Zoom call, but a 3-way call with like a month ago. And she, you know, so you don't know, it may not even happen this week, but you're planting those seeds. So
mm-hmm.
That's what we're doing.
I'm sure that all of that work, I mean, that's going to really come to fruition probably even months down the road, right?
Yeah.
Kind of the cycle of our business, what we do now shows up in a couple of months. So that's really great.
And just getting our newbies, like when a new person calls, like mm-hmm. I had one today, she actually did cancel on me. Mm-hmm. She just joined Friday and I told her, listen, let's get your products covered. Mm-hmm. I said, and she was like, well, I don't know that they would really want it. I was like, don't get that. Like, it's okay. just tell them you want their support, because you don't know who really wants it or not. And you don't know how to answer anybody yet. You know what I mean? Like, I don't expect you, just like when she's a nurse. So I was like, your first day on the job with nursing, somebody walked around with you and told you what to do. So that's what I'm here for. So just let me talk to them for you and just give them a little hint of what this is, if anything, so they could support you. Because you're going to need support from your friends and family too, whether they join you or not. And she was like, okay, you know, but she did cancel on me today, but we rescheduled. So if she cancels, we're doing it Thursday night, hopefully.
Awesome.
Really good. Yeah. Beauty of all of this, is if this is something we can all do, three-way calls, Zooms, whatever, the duplication. That is, I mean, I will say that was not something I was taught when I started. And you know what I mean? Because it's not, it's because a lot of us didn't even know diddly about network marketing. I mean, even the ones at the top are still learning. So, but this is something, if you look at, she mentioned Amy Pohl, Sarah Taylor, Tamara Holloway, these people have figured out, and Amy is figuring it out too, it seems like, the duplication, because she just said, like, I'm doing a six-week group, but my leaders are doing it too. Getting your leaders on board. If you are a senior Ruby, that means you have some goals and stuff under you. Those are leaders. And showing by example, they are going to duplicate it. And it's easily duplicable. And that's, I think, that's the best part of all of it.
Yeah, we actually, the reason I was late, I just popped on, like, I think right around the time you did, Arge, but I was on we do a weekly Zoom call with all of our groups, like all six of our leaders groups, you know, we're all doing, there's six of us hosting them. And so we talked about this tonight and I told them, your goal this week is to do it with your partner, like without me. So now you and your partner are going to host that together. And then next week, you're going to do this for your downline. Like those people that are on, you're doing it for them. And I'll pop on as I can if you want, but you don't need me. Cause I actually had, and I told them this, one of my very best friends, I could not, a year and a half, she would not try the products. Oh, Amy, I'm so happy for you and your business, but I've got a real issue. And her diagnosis was bacteria in her gut. And I'm like, oh my goodness. Like she wouldn't hear it from me. I sent her the video. She would not listen to me at all. And then one day, my leaders and I were, because this Zoom thing is not brand new to me. I've really been, it was like a light bulb went on when Amy Pohl said it, but I've been trying to get this going for a while. Like I've heard it for a while and I've practiced here and there, but I never knew how to get it started. But I actually did one with just my leaders. We were practicing and we were just trying to get the potentials to get on. And so when we were practicing, I said to my best friend, I was like, listen, so-and-so has very similar story to you. Just get on and hear her, please. And this girl was only trying, she was only going to do the probiotic. And she ended up getting the Triflex and the X Factor, just hearing my friend's story. So that's really all we're trying to do. Like if you know someone like you really want on your team or a customer and they're really struggling with migraines, get me on the phone with them. Like I would do it for a sideline. Yeah, I know all of you would, you know what I mean? It doesn't even have to be a leader. It could be someone in your downline, anyone that has a story that's similar. So I feel like that's really all we're doing. Nothing special. It's just a matter of doing it.
Yeah. Good.
I don't use a PowerPoint. I kept asking, and I asked the other ladies the same thing. I haven't. I mean, I have in the past, but it just gets really long, and nobody feels like they can talk, I feel like. When I start off at talking to the potentials and, you know, asking them what they think, and are you here just to support your friend, or are you actually – interested in what we're going to talk about tonight. You know, every conversation, every call went differently, every one of them.
That's really, I love that. Cause I'm, like I said, kind of doing the same model this week with the challenge group. And they keep asking me like, what are we supposed to do? I'm like, we're going to keep it informal. It's going to be questions. It's going to be getting, cause that just knowing that we're going into it like that actually makes me feel kind of more at ease too. Like, we'll be fine. We're just going to ask a bunch of questions. It's going to be all good. So good. Yes. So thank you, Amy. Okay. Anybody else have anything they want to add? This was great. Really good. Good stuff. Anybody have anything they want to add or questions? Anyone?
I have a question. Who's going to be at Leaders Jewel Training next week? Anyone? I can't be the only one. Jewel training?
No, I wish.
Oh my goodness, I'm so excited.
Amber's gonna be there.
Yay.
Yes. And y'all, and I know you got most of the people on here are probably senior rubies getting ready to be emerald. That jewels training is amazing. It totally rocked my business, just trying to change my perspective. And so get excited about that, because I think that to me is really showing what corporate is doing, that they are really understanding, with the Mary Ann and her team understanding, that it's so important to really focus on leader and leadership training and training us, like, how to be. We're kind of like, you guys know this, we're pioneers in this company. We're like trailblazers. It's so brand new. And there's so many leaders that are being born every day as we add them. And so they're training us to be able to be the kinds of leaders that represent Plexus in just an amazing way. So anyway, it's very exciting. It's a very exciting time to be where we are in this company. So, you know, if you're going Emerald this month, you're going to rock it. And if you're going next month, or maybe it's not until July, and that's, you know, it's just, no matter when it happens, it's so sweet and so wonderful. Okay. So it's been like, it's like 10:30 now on the East Coast. I need to go to bed. But so great, you guys, that everybody got on. I hope that everybody got something out of it. And yeah, this is just great. And we will we'll keep doing the Friday. So if you're a senior ruby or jewel or whatever, we do these kind of things every Friday morning at 10 o'clock. We usually post it on the Emeralds page, the Emerald Rockstars. But really, it's turned in, we all started out as senior rubies, but now a lot of us are getting to Emerald. So it's turned into a gem jewel brainstorm. So it's good stuff. All right, guys. Thank you, everybody that contributed tonight. Thanks, everybody that jumped on. And God bless everybody. Bye.